the mayor pro tem went through some of the significant issues that we did last night. I think what's on our agenda for the upcoming year, in addition to those things, is that we are really trying to focus on how we're going to move people around the city with the development that's taking place, and how are we going to fix this disparate development between areas in the south and where we are in the west. And so for me, when I look at this, I say, how are we going to get the transportation infrastructure to the west side so that people can come and develop and build here? And that is one of the key things that we've got. South Park, you're getting, we get about 15 to 20 zoning petitions a month. Most of our time, when we're there till midnight, it's because we're deciding land use issues around development. There are very few of those things, and Al's been working so hard on this. I want you to know that you guys have got a great person in Al's representation, because he's talking about how are we going to develop from the Johnson and Wales out Bates Ford Road in a way that works to make this the kind of employment corridor that we need. So that's one of the things that we really have to keep our eye on. The other thing that I think is really important is development is really good, but it's only good if we build it in a way that people can live in it. We don't want to continue to force people out of their neighborhoods. We don't want to have people not have the ability to walk around a neighborhood. The biggest economic development tool I think you can give a young couple is to make sure that they don't have to have a second car. You know, when you think about a car payment, the car insurance, the car property tax, the vehicle license tax, the state taxes on it, that can be as much as $3,000 to $4,000 in a young person's household. And if you can get people that are couples raising their families and say you don't have to have a second car, it's meaningful. So we need to be looking at a way to make sure that we have a transit system that works, that we have places that people can walk. When you live in Macquarie Heights, you ought to be able to walk to a place that gets you to the streetcar, that gets you to downtown for employment or further out. So that's one of the things we need to keep our eye on. And as always, I have to mention the budget. It's just something, when we talk about it at council, it really does impact people's lives. So we're talking about the water pool rates, we're talking about storm water, what needs to be done, and what we built as a system, how do we make it meet expectations, but yet balance what it costs. And so those are the things that we need to look at, and how are we going to deal with our budget issues, because many of them are created by the impact of what Representative Earle and Cunningham have said. If the state decides to redistribute sales tax income, where we spend all this money letting people build shopping centers and have businesses, and they take the sales tax and take it away, we would lose, I think, isn't it like $29 million or more? It's a number that's so big, it's just something that we've got to ask. I know the Democrats are not leading the effort, but we can't just talk to the Democrats. We've got to talk to those Republicans about why Charlotte builds jobs for the region, not just for Charlotte. So with that, I'll turn it over to David.
The only thing I'll add to the budget conversation is that we actually have a current issue we have to deal with, and that's the elimination of the business privilege tax. It's going to cause us about $18 million hole that we got to figure out how to dig out of. And given what Carla and Representative Earle just said, I want to hear a source coming to fill that. So we're not exactly sure if that's raising taxes, if that's a lot of cuts. We're not sure what we have to do. So that's probably more immediate that we have to figure out. The only other thing I'll tell you is that, of course, since some of the issues we dealt with the former mayor, we've been trying to figure out what we need to do with our ethics policy. The committee that I'm chairing is actually looking at what do we need to do, and we're looking at three areas. We're looking at our disclosure forms. How do we beef that up? We're probably going to follow kind of closely the forms that the state instituted a couple of years ago. That's going from one page to a lot of pages, so we're trying to get our hands around that. We're looking at our gifts policy, actually what we're allowed to accept, not accept. And we're actually looking at council investigations when there are actually complaints about us. Who actually investigates it? Right now it's the city attorney, and the city attorney reports to us, so that could be a little bit just a little bit. So we're trying to work through that and come with some suggestions, and hopefully You haven't heard us talk about it a lot in public, but we've been talking about it quite a bit where we can. So hopefully that'll be something that you'll start to hear us talk about over the next several months as well. The only other thing that I want to let you know is that we instituted an immigration task force, not an immigration, an immigrant integration task force about a year ago. And we've asked them to come back with some suggestions on how to better make Charlotte feel more welcoming to people from other places. And they're supposed to give us suggestions in the next month or so as well. And Vi was being a little modest. She and I had an opportunity to go to D.C. to meet with actually former mayor and current secretary of transportation, Fox. He was here probably about 2 months ago for a conference. We had a chance to talk to him one-on-one, and he gave us some suggestions of actually engaging his department more to help us figure out transit, something that's kind of got us hung up right now. And we actually went up with Carolyn Flowers, with Mayor Swain from Huntersville, to sit with his staff. I mean, you know, we had a chance to interact with people with finance and with people with
process improvement.
So, I mean,
and details.
Public-private partnerships. We spent a day up there and actually have sent information back to them, hoping that now they can help us figure out how to come up with other sources, how to come up with other ways to fund our transit system. So.
There is good news I want to share, and that's about crime in Charlotte. Hopefully you read the Observer most recently that crime in Charlotte overall has gone down. The issue, though, however, is that in my district, in the Metro District, which comprises District 2 and District 3, that's not necessarily so. So in 2013, I think we had like 58 murders citywide. For 2014, we're at 42 murders, and 11 of those are in our Metro District, which is the district I represent. Now, that's disturbing to me. And so what we're going to be doing actually on this coming Saturday is that the 18 presidents that are along Betty's Fork Road and all of the neighborhoods, we're going to be meeting with Chief Monroe to really have a detailed and honest conversation about crime in our communities. You know, we've got a lot of national attention recently about white police killing black people. There's all this campaign about Black Lives Matter, and I'm one that all life matters. All life matters. The 11 murders that we had were by people of the same race. The victim and the suspect were all of the same race. So we really need to have a dialogue. And unfortunately, there wasn't that outrage in our communities about that. And that's disturbing. So what we're going to do this Saturday with the 18 presidents, really have an honest and detailed conversation about crime in our communities. And that's a concern for me. As Bob stated, I'm trying to bring in developers to kind of look at our community, to look at LaSalle and Bayesville Road, because that's the Wall Street of the black community, as I knew it when I was growing up. And that needs to be uplifted, that needs to be worked on. There are things going on there that I don't like, the neighbors don't like, and so we need to get our hand around it. And I'm not sure how we're going to get around it, but I know it kind of started with us. We can't police our way out of that situation. It has been an ongoing situation for decades along Bayesville Road. There are drug sales, there's prostitution along the Roswell's Ferry Road. These are ills. These are ills in our society, and our community won't tolerate it. And they've been on me to put pressure on the police, but then we get in a situation where people are feeling like they're being profiled and those types of things, but these same people are doing the crimes and things in our community are hurting our communities. So that's my focus coming this year. I've been trying to get my hand around many issues around economic development in District 2, crime, as well as community development. So that's kind of where I'm at going into 2015. Well, Captain Harris and Major Dalton, they're working closer with the communities, and lieutenants have been in the community and got community police officers that are trying to address many of the issues at Five Points, at LaSalle, as well as Lancaster as well. They can only do as much as our criminal justice system will really allow. Here's what's happening. We will arrest. Unfortunately, our court system will release and release and release. And so they're back into our communities, and so we arrest them again. So we've been working closely with Ann Thompson.
Thompson.
Yes. To see what we can do to strengthen that kind of connection so that the district attorneys, the court systems understands that these individuals get arrested, we really don't want them back in the community. One of the things that we're going to be bringing up in our public safety committee, and Michael and I are on that committee, is an exclusionary rule similar to what happened in Hidden Valley, where we had gangs kind of infesting that area over there. We're wanting to do something similar that will address in District 4, District 3, and District 2. So if you get arrested these multiple times, that they won't be able to come back.
As we've actually said that we wanted to start with the issues that were violated. And not all of the issues that were violated by the past mayor had anything to do with some of the things we're talking about. So we're trying to make sure we keep that focus there. The community as a whole is trying to push us in a different direction. So one of the reasons why we took our time, there was a lot of pressure on us to react right away. And we've taken our time now, we've taken, 8 months, 9 months, to make sure we do exactly what you said. That we deal with the fact that what we heard was that there was undue openness to the permitting process. So we're reviewing the permitting process along with everything else to make sure that we're dealing with gifts. Well, now we're not going to overdo the gifts because we know that, in general, we don't get the kind of gifts that we're talking about in that situation. So, we're trying our best, but trust our colleagues, our other colleagues are pushing us as hard as they can to go lockstep with exactly what you guys need.